Good day and welcome to the NMIS Meat Importers Virtual Orientation. This is prepared by the Meat Import Export Division by the National Meat Inspection Service. In this orientation, you will be guided and oriented on the following content. Part one will be on the legal basis and overview of the meat importation process. Part two will be on the importer licensing process, which will talk about the procedures, classification of importers, requirements, affidavit of undertaking. This will be then followed by part three for the pre-border, border, post-border inspection procedures, which will be tackling more on the inspection at the port, at the cold storage warehouse. Also, you will be oriented on how to request for transfer of your direct arrivals to the cold storage warehouses and the request for the certificate of meat inspection. Last but not the least will be part four, which is on violations and penalties on meat importation. Please note that after your virtual orientation, you'll be guided to an online quiz which will assess your knowledge assimilation, and only those that will pass the online quiz will be given a certificate of attendance for this said virtual orientation. So this slide shows the legal basis for meat importation into the Philippines. The National Meat Inspection Service is the sole national controlling authority over meat inspection and hygiene. The Meat Import Export Division in particular is the one responsible for evaluating foreign meat establishment intending to export into the country, accredit meat importers and exporters, inspect and certify imported and exported meat, and provide technical assistance to both importers and exporters. On the left side of your screen, you can see the list of legislations that covers inspection of imported meat, starting off with Republic Act Number 9296, as amended by RA 10536, or the Meat Inspection Code of the Philippines and its implementing rules and regulations. Another regulation is RA Number 10611, or the Food Safety Act and its IRR. And the following are administrative orders, which covers the licensing of importers, the procedures of pre-inspection at the cold storage warehouse and at the port, as well as the pre-border measures in accrediting foreign meat establishments. The following are DAAO number 26, series of 2005, DAAO number 16, series of 2006, DAAO 9, series of 2010, and DAAO number 16, series of 2001. We highly recommend that you go to our website, which is www.nmis.gov.ph, where you can see the said regulations. Please do read on it, as there is a saying that ignorance of the law is no excuse. This is to provide you further guidance on the current or existing regulations that we have. So the next slide is just a brief review or a brief process flow on the importation of meat into the country, which is separated by first the pre-border inspection process, followed by the border and post-border inspection processes. For the pre-border inspection processes, this covers the accreditation of the foreign meat establishments where the source of imported meat comes from. Also the importer's accreditation or licensing, and next followed by the applications for the sanitary and phytosanitary import clearance. Once you're an accredited importer and you have applied an SPSIEC from an accredited foreign meat establishment or country, you may now process your shipments to come into the country, which will then undergo inspection at the port by the BAI Veterinary Quarantine Services along with the Bureau of Customs on tarification. Then this, after it is cleared at the port, their meat or shipments will be inspected at the cold storage warehouses by our NMIS plant officers. Once that is cleared, you may now store your imported meat at the cold storage warehouses. And if you wish to use the imported meat for local consumption, it will undergo an inspection again by our NMIS plant officer prior to its withdrawal at the cold storage warehouse. For each country or FME accreditation, each country has a list of meat or commodities allowed to be exported to the country. There are also countries which only have specific establishment allowed to export, such as India, where only limited or a number of foreign meat establishments are allowed to export buffalo meat. At the DA website, which you see here at the bottom, there is a list of temporary bans which are constantly being issued if there are occurrences of animal diseases or zoonotic diseases. You may check it out at the DA website. So for the licensing of the meat importers, only DA accredited or NMIS licensed meat importers are eligible to import meat into the country. As a meat importer, you are considered as a food business operator. Thus, it is your responsibility to ensure that meat imported satisfies our food or meat law and the control systems are in place to prevent, eliminate, or reduce the risk to consumers. This slide shows the different processes that you will be encountering when you import meat. As discussed earlier, for the pre-importation process or the pre-border process, this includes accreditation of the country and the foreign meat establishment, and of course, the licensing of you as a meat importer. Once you have been licensed by NMIS, you may now apply through the DA Trade System or Intercommerce Network Services, an SPS import clearance, which will be approved by the BAE quarantine. Once you have your SPS clearance and it arrives at the port, this will be examined by the BOC as well as the BAE VTO, and then your shipment will then be released to a cold storage warehouse where the inspection upon arrival will be done by the NMIS plant officers. Withdrawal of your goods for local consumption. We also have an issuance of certificate of meat inspection.